वेलकम टू माय क्लास क्लास 12 फिजिक्स फर्स्ट चैप्टर दैट इज इलेक्ट्रिक चार्जेस एंड फील्ड्स एंड मेन पॉइंट ऑफ डिस्कशन टुडे दैट इज द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ गॉस लॉ एंड वी विल कैलकुलेट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ड्यू टू ए यूनिफॉर्मली चार्ज्ड इनफाइनाइटली प्लेन शीट. दिस इज द सेकेंड एप्लीकेशन ऑफ गॉस लॉ एंड यू टेक ए uniformly charged plane sheet suppose this one the charged plane sheet and suppose this is a positively charged plate uniformly positively charged plate and all the charges are closely packed. All the positive charges are closely packed. That means distance between two charges is very very small. That is negligible. And that is the case of a continuous charge distribution because all the charges are uniformly spread throughout the sheet and closely packed with a small distance between them, so that this is known as the continuous charge distribution. And you know three types of continuous charge distributions are there. One is your line charge distribution, that is also known as the linear charge distribution, and this one second type, that is the surface charge distribution, and another is your volume charge distribution. And suppose here total surface area, we write suppose S. S is the total surface area and total charge suppose Q. Then you know the surface charge density and symbol for surface charge density, that is sigma. Sigma is equal to, that is known as surface charge density. And surface charge density means, you know that, that is total charge. Total charge divided by surface area. And from this expression, we also write Q is equal to sigma multiplied by S. And this is the expression of surface charge density. Surface charge density means total charge per unit surface area. Suppose you take a unit surface area and total charge inside the surface area is known as the surface charge density. And this is a uniform surface charge density and suppose that is sigma. Clear? And you take an observation point. Suppose this one is the observation point. And at this point, suppose we will calculate the magnitude and direction of the electric field. And here we take a small area. Here you take a small area in the form of a circle, suppose. And you draw the Gaussian surface. You know Gaussian surface is a closed surface. Gaussian surface may be cylindrical, may be cube, may be your spherical. But here we take the Gaussian surface as a cylindrical surface. And passing through the observation point, and suppose this one is your cylindrical Gaussian surface, similarly we draw Gaussian surface in the back side. This is the Gaussian surface, cylindrical Gaussian surface. And this is the length of the Gaussian surface in the front side of the plate, that is suppose R. And this is the length of the Gaussian surface back side of the plate or plane sheet, that is also R. Clear? And suppose surface area of this circular surface, we write suppose that is S. Clear? Then you know always direction of electric field lines or electric field is outward from a positive charged plate and towards or inward to a negative charged plate. You know that. And in this case, here also we write, this is known as the Gaussian surface. This surface is known as the Gaussian surface. And this Gaussian surface, here three surfaces are there. One surface, this is the first surface. First surface is a circular cross section, and this is the second surface. Second surface is a curved cylindrical surface, just like this. And this is the third surface. Third surface is also a circular cross section. Three surfaces are there. And here we applied the Gauss law on this Gaussian surface for all the three surfaces. And for the first surface, this is the surface area vector. This is the direction of the surface area vector. For surface area vector, we write suppose ds vector, because you know the surface area vector or area vector. Area vector means, suppose this one is your area. Suppose this is a small element of area, or this is a area, simply area. And area vector means perpendicular to the surface area. This is the direction of the area vector, you know that. And here also, this is a circular cross section. This is a circular cross section, and this is the total area. This is the total area, and area vector is perpendicular to this area. So that we write that is the ds vector. And for the first surface, what is the direction? Direction of the electric field, you know. Always direction of electric field is outward from a positive charged plate. And here also, this is the direction. This is the direction of the electric field. We write that is E vector. That means both electric field and area vector, both are parallel to each other. If both are parallel to each other, we write simply angle between these two vectors in the first surface, for the first surface, that is theta is equal to 0 degree. This is for the first circular cross-sectional surface. Clear? Second. For the second surface, here we also draw area vector. Area vector is always perpendicular to the surface. This is the area vector. We write that is ds vector, because area vector is perpendicular to the surface. Clear? Similarly, direction of electric field. This is the direction of the electric field, always outward. Direction of electric field is always outward from the positively charged plate. We write this is E vector, because this is the positively charged plate, so that this is the direction of the electric field in the front side, and this is the direction of the electric field in the back side. And here, angle between electric field vector and area vector, that is theta is equal to 90 degree for the second surface, second curved cylindrical surface. Similarly, this one is the third surface also circular cross section, and for this surface, first we draw the surface area vector or area vector, and this is the area vector. This is area vector. We write that is ds vector, that means perpendicular to this surface area. Similarly, direction of electric field for the third surface, outward from the positive charge plate, because this is the positive charge plate. So the direction of electric field is outward. We write that is E vector. And in this case also, same thing, direction of electric field and area vector, both are parallel. If both are parallel to each other, we write here theta is equal to 0 degree. फॉर द थर्ड सरफेस थीटा इज 0 डिग्री, फॉर द सेकेंड सरफेस थीटा इज इक्वल टू 90 डिग्री, एंड फॉर द फर्स्ट सरफेस थीटा इज इक्वल टू ऑल्सो 0 डिग्री। क्लियर? नाउ वी अप्लाइड गॉस लॉ, वी नो गॉस लॉ, फ्रॉम गॉस लॉ from Gauss law we get that is phi, phi is your electric flux is equal to total charge divided by epsilon 0. Q is the total charge inside the closed Gaussian surface, not outside the Gaussian surface, and phi is your electric flux. Electric flux means number of lines of force or number of field lines passing through this surface area normally is known as the electric flux. Suppose three lines or three field lines passing through this surface area normally or perpendicularly, and we write flux is equal to 3. If four number of field lines passing, we write flux is equal to 4. Clear? And that implies, you know the mathematical expression of a flux, that is integration over a closed surface. This circle means that is a closed surface and that is the Gaussian surface. Vector E dot ds vector is equal to Q divided by epsilon 0. That implies your three surfaces are there, so that the left hand side we divide into three parts. This is the integration for the first closed surface. Vector E dot ds vector plus integration for the second surface, vector E dot ds vector plus for the third surface, vector E dot ds vector is equal to charge Q divided by epsilon 0. That implies we write integration for the first surface, this is E vector dot ds vector, that is A dot B, A vector dot B vector. You know A vector dot B vector, that is AB cos theta. Here also we put the same formula. We write that is E ds cos theta. Theta is the angle between E vector and ds vector for first surface. And look at the figure. This is the first surface. For first surface, angle theta is equal to 0 degree. So that we write, in place of theta, we write that is cos 0 degree. Plus, for the second surface, we write integration of E ds cos, for the second surface, what is the angle? Angle between E vector and ds vector, that is theta is equal to 90 degree. So that we write in place of theta, that is 90 degree, plus integration for the third surface, we write E ds cos, and for the third surface, third circular surface, here also theta is equal to 0 degree, we write in place of theta, that is 0 degree is equal to Q divided by epsilon 0. And you know the value of cos 0, cos 0 is equal to 1, and cos 90 is equal to 0, so that second term is equal to 0, and in place of cos 0, here also we put 1, then remaining is equal to, we write that implies integration for the first surface E ds in place of cos 0 we put 1, so that simply that is integration of ds plus second term is 0, and third term that is also simply integration of ds plus second term is 0, third term integration for the third surface, simply write E ds is equal to Q divided by epsilon 0. That implies E, we take E out of the integration, integration of ds plus E integration of ds is equal to Q by epsilon 0. That implies E, you know, integration of ds, that is S plus, here also integration of ds, we write that is S is equal to Q by epsilon 0. What is Q? Look at the figure. Q, sigma is known as Q by S. Sigma is the surface charge density. So that Q is equal to sigma multiplied by S. So that in place of Q, we write sigma, that is the surface charge density, multiplied by S, divided by epsilon 0. That implies this is ES plus ES, twice of ES is equal to sigma S divided by epsilon 0. And S, S cancel in both the sides. Remaining is equal to E is equal to, we take 2 to the right hand side. So that this is sigma divided by twice epsilon 0. This is the magnitude of electric field. This is the magnitude of electric field at the observation point. That means at point P. This point is P point. This point is P point, observation point. At this point, magnitude of electric field due to a uniformly charged, uniformly positively charged plane sheet is sigma divided by twice epsilon 0. And this is in the scalar form. This is the magnitude of electric field in scalar form. Clear? Similarly, in vector form, we write, in vector form, we write E vector, because electric field is a vector quantity, is equal to sigma by twice epsilon 0 multiplied by n cap. N cap is the direction, or that is also known as the unit vector. This is in vector form. And this n cap is positive. N cap is positive if sigma is positive. That means if the plane sheet is positively charged, then in this case, electric field or direction of the electric field is outward from the positive charged plate. So that is positive. And you also write n cap or direction of electric field is towards the plate. Direction of electric field is towards the plate or inward. We write just like this. Direction of electric field is inward if sigma, this is sigma, if sigma is negative. Clear? Direction of electric field is inward if surface charge density is negative. And you also write here same thing. Here also we write direction of E is outward. We write here outward. In the first case, direction of electric field is outward if sigma is positive. In the second case, direction of electric field is inward if sigma is negative. Clear? And suppose we take a finite thickness plate. If thickness of plane sheet is finite, if thickness of the plane sheet is finite, then what happened? Suppose this is your plane sheet. Suppose this is a thick plane sheet. Then two surfaces are there. This is the front surface and this one is the back surface. And here we will calculate the electric field for both the surface, for the front surface and also for the back surface. So that we write net electric field E is equal to, for the front surface or for one surface, you know, electric field is equal to sigma divided by twice epsilon 0. And for another surface, electric field, that is also sigma divided by twice epsilon 0. That implies net electric field is equal to twice of sigma divided by twice epsilon 0. That implies we write electric field due to a finite thickness plate, 2 2 cancel. Remaining is equal to sigma by epsilon 0. This is the electric field for a finite thickness plate. Clear? But for a thin plane sheet, electric field is equal to sigma by twice epsilon 0. This is for the thin. And electric field E is equal to sigma by epsilon 0. This is for a thick plane sheet. Only this is the difference. Suppose another case. We take two plane sheet, we take two parallel plane sheet. We write heading field due to two parallel plane sheet. And both are charged plane sheet. Suppose both are positively charged plane sheet. Suppose this is the first plane sheet. And that is positively charged, uniformly charged, closely packed, gap is very, very small, so that is continuous charge distribution. And it's a surface charge density of the first plate. Suppose we write that is sigma 1. This is the surface charge density of the first positive charged plate. We take another charged plate. Both are parallel to each other. We take another charged plate. And second one, that is also positive charged plate. These are the positive charged, closely packed, same thing, just like the first one, but surface charge density is different. Suppose surface charge density of the second plate is sigma 2, clear? And you know, surface charge density, sigma 1, we write that is, you know the formula of surface charge density. Surface charge density, that is Q divided by surface area. We write for the first case, that is Q1 by S. And for the second case, we write that is surface charge density sigma 2 is equal to Q2 divided by S. Clear? Then, here three regions are there. This is the first region outside the of the both the plate. This is the second region. We write second region. This is in between the two plate. And this is the third region. This is also the outside. This one is the first region. And for the first region, what is the direction of the electric field? Suppose only one plate is there. Only first plate is there. And for the first plate, and second plate is absent. No second plate is there. If only one plate is there for the first plate and for the first region, this is the direction of the electric field. Because you know, direction of electric field is always outward, from the positive charged plate. And for the first plate, we write that is E1 vector. Always outward. So for this one is the positive charged plate direction of electric field is always outward, is always outward from the positive charged plate. Similarly, for the second region, this is the direction of the electric field for the first positively charged plate. Here also, for the third region, this is the direction of the electric field or E1 vector, because always electric field vector is outward from the positive charged plate. Clear? Similarly, suppose only second plate is there and first plate is not there, and for the second plate, this is the direction of electric field. We write that is E2 vector, because second plate is also positively charged. And here also direction of electric field is outward from the positive charged plate. And this is the direction of the electric field for the second charged plate, because direction of the electric field is outward from the positive charged plate. And this is the direction of the electric field for the second charged plate in the first region. That is E2 vector. Clear? And you know the magnitude of electric field for one thin plane sheet. We write that is, for the first plate, we write that is E1. E1 is equal to, its surface charge density is sigma 1 divided by twice epsilon 0. Clear? This is the electric field for the first positively charged plate. Similarly, for the second plate, this is for the first plate. For the second plate, we write magnitude of electric field is E2 is equal to sigma 2. Sigma 2 is the surface charge density divided by twice epsilon 0. This is the magnitude of electric field for the second positively charged plate. Then in the first region, what is the net electric field? We write in region 1. In the first region, net electric field is E for first region is equal to, in the first region, total electric field is equal to E1 vector plus E2 vector. Here you apply the principle of superposition. So that we write net electric field E1 is equal to, this is the E1, this is not E1, this is electric field for the first region is equal to E1, this is for the first plate, plus electric field due to the second plate, that is E2 vector. And we write net electric field in the first region is equal to E1 vector. E1, its magnitude is sigma 1 divided by twice epsilon 0. And its direction, suppose, this is the positive x-axis, and this one is the negative x-axis. Then in the first region, direction of E1 vector is along the negative x-axis. So that we write for direction, that is minus n cap. For direction, we write minus n cap. And for magnitude, we write sigma 1 divided by twice epsilon 0. Direction is minus n cap. This is the electric field in the first region due to the first charged plate. Similarly, for the second charged plate, electric field is sigma 2 divided by twice epsilon 0. Its direction is also along the negative x-axis. We write that is minus n cap. Clear? That implies net electric field E is equal to, here we take 1 by twice epsilon 0 as a common. Remaining is equal to, here sigma 1 plus, here that is sigma 2 multiplied by direction is minus n cap. This is the net electric field in the first region. Or this is the total electric field in the first region. Clear? Similarly, in the second region, in this region, what is the net electric field? We write same thing. In region 2, net electric field in the second region is equal to one electric field, that is E1 vector, another g2 vector and you know the magnitude of p1 vector, that is sigma 1 divided by twice epsilon 0, and its direction, direction of p1 vector, that is along the positive x-axis, we write plus n cap. For e2 vector, this is the case of, this is e2 vector, and e2 vector, its direction, we write that is minus n cap. e2 vector, that is minus n cap, e1 vector, that is plus n cap. And this is the electric field in the second region for the first positively charged plate plus E2 vector. We write that is sigma 2, this is the surface charge density, divided by twice epsilon 0, direction is along the negative x-axis, we write that is minus n cap. And finally we write net electric field in the second region is equal to, we take 1 by twice epsilon 0 as a common, remaining is equal to here sigma 1, here suppose you take minus, that is minus sigma 2 multiplied by direction is n cap. And this is the final expression of electric field in between the two plates, in between the two plates. Suppose one case, one special case. Suppose surface charge density of both the plates are same. If surface charge density of both the plates are same, then sigma 1 is equal to sigma 2. And in place of sigma 1, in place of sigma 1 minus sigma 2, we write 0. We write here, if sigma 1 is equal to sigma 2, then net electric field in between the two plates is equal to 0. This is the net electric field in between the two parallel plates, in between the two parallel positive charged plates, net electric field in between these two plates is 0. And what is the condition? Condition is surface charge density of both the plates suppose constant or same. Similarly, for the third region, and this is the last region, we write net electric field E vector is equal to electric field due to the first charged plate plus electric field due to the second charged plate. We write net electric field is equal to, you know the magnitude of E1 vector, that is sigma 1 divided by twice epsilon 0. And what is its direction? Look at the figure. This is the third region and this is the direction of E1 vector, that is outward or along the positive x-axis, we write n cap, plus n cap. And for E2 vector, we also write direction, that is plus n cap, because both are along the positive x-axis. And we write that is n cap. This is the electric field due to the first plate in region 3 plus same thing, sigma 2 divided by twice epsilon 0 n cap. Clear? That implies net electric field in the third region, we take 1 by twice epsilon 0 as a common, remaining is equal to sigma 1, sigma 2 multiplied by its direction, that is n cap. So the direction of the net electric field, direction of net electric field is along the positive x-axis, that means in this direction. Clear? Suppose another case is there, another case is there, field due to two parallel plane sheet but oppositely charged. Opposite charge means first plate suppose positive charged and second plate suppose negative charged. Clear? And we take two charged plate suppose this one is the first charged plate that is positively charged, and suppose its surface charge density, we write suppose sigma, not sigma 1, we write suppose sigma. Similarly, we take another charged plate, second charged plate, and second charged plate, suppose that is negatively charged. Suppose this is a negatively charged plate, then what happened? And its surface charge density is also sigma. That means surface charge density of both the plates are same. Clear? Then this is the second region, or in between the two plates. This one is the first region, and this one is the third region. And in the second region, this is the direction of electric field for the first positive charged plate, that is E1 vector. And in the first region, this is the direction of the electric field for the first positive charged plate. And for the first plate, in the third region, this is the direction of electric field, because always direction of electric field is outward from a positive charged plate. Clear? Similarly, for the second plate is a negative charged, so that inward or towards the plate, this is the direction of electric field for the second charged plate in second region. And this is also direction of electric field, that is E2 vector, that means towards the second plate. Here also same thing, this is the direction of electric field towards the second plate. We write that is E2 vector. Clear? Then in the second region, or in between the two plates, what is the net electric field? We calculate net electric field in the second region. We write net electric field is E. E is equal to E1 vector plus E2 vector, and this is in the second region. Second region means in between the two parallel plates. We write net electric field E. E vector is equal to, what is E1 vector? Its magnitude is sigma divided by twice epsilon 0. Its direction is along positive x-axis, so that we write n cap plus E2 vector. That is also direction in the same direction as E1 vector. We write sigma divided by twice epsilon 0, and that is also n cap. Here we write sigma, here also we write sigma, because surface charge density of both the plates are same, suppose. If different, here we write sigma 1 and here we write sigma 2. That implies E vector is equal to, this is sigma by twice epsilon 0 plus sigma by twice epsilon 0. We write sigma by epsilon 0 multiplied by n cap. This is the net electric field in between two charged plates. One is positive, another is negative. And this electric field is uniform. This electric field is uniform. That means if we take two infinite plane sheet, one is positive charged, another is negative charged, in between the two plates, electric field is constant, and that is sigma divided by epsilon 0. Clear? And this is all about your second application of Gauss law. And in the next class, we will discuss about third application of Gauss law, that is electric field due to a thin spherical shell. And thank you.